This video is part 2 of a series of 3 where I show you how to crochet this pattern. Okay, we have done the first part of this pattern where we did increases on both sides of the piece, and now we will want to go in a straight line. So that means that we have now 13 stitches on this piece, and that will remain 13 stitches. On the right side, you do an increase at the bottom, and you will do a decrease at the upper side. And then when you turn around again, you decrease. And when you come back to this side, you will do an increase. And that is what I will show you now. So this is row 7. And well, the first part is like the other parts. So you will first start with making your increase and making that first double crochet by making 2 single crochets on top of each other, and an increase with a double crochet. And then you will work through this row until you've come to the last 2 stitches. So I will see you when I am back there. I'm almost at the end of this row. You can count now. I have done 2 increases here, for 1 increase, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So if I want to remain at 13 stitches, then I have to do an increase here, a decrease here, sorry. And then we will just do 2 double crochets together. And it goes like this. You first do the first part of the double crochet, but then you don't pull through the last part. And then in the last stitch, you will also do the first part of a double crochet. So you wrap your yarn around the hook, pull it through, work through the first part. So now you can see that you have done these 2 parts of the double crochets, and then you pull the yarn through all 3 loops. So now you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 stitches. So that's okay. You can also count it here. If it's correct, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. We have come to the next row, and here is something special going on, because now you have to make a decrease at the start of your row, and that goes a little bit different. Well, first you start with making a single crochet in this first stitch, like you've done before. You can also see that here. And now you are going to do 1 chain stitch. So that's different. And this part doesn't count. Beware of that. Next, you will do a double crochet. This counts as a decrease, and this is your first stitch. Mark that. That is very important. So this is not your first stitch. This, the top of your double crochet, that's the first stitch that you count on this row. So now I will again make a front post treble crochets till I'm nearly at the end, and there we will do a decrease, but I will do that when the camera is off, and I will see you then. I just said that we will put the camera out, but I wanted to show you this. This is the spot where you have done your double crochet, and this is the first post that you have to work around. So not this post, this next post after the double crochet that you did here. So I will show you. So this is the first one. And then I will continue till I'm at the end of the row. I'm almost at the end of this row. I have to do one more front post treble crochet. You can see here that here's the last stitch and here is this last post that you have to work around. So do that last one. And then we will do an increase in this last stitch. So now we will count again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So we are still on 14 stitches. And now on this side you can see that the top side goes that way. So you will get a straight way. Well, the next rows you will repeat this. So you will, on the right side, you will do an increase at the start and a decrease at the end, and when you go back you will do a decrease like this and do an increase at the end when you've come back here. So I will show you the finishing and the start of both sides one more time, and you repeat these two rows as much as you like your piece to be. But I will first do two more times, show you how to do this. An increase like you usually do, with that special double crochet I learned you. And then double crochet till the end, and I see you back when I'm at the end. So again, I've come to the end of my row, so I will do a double crochet two together. So this is the first part. This is the second part in the last stitch, and then pull the yarn through all three loops, and then I will continue right away with the other one. Do your single crochet in the first stitch here, do a chain, but this doesn't count as a stitch. Then do a double crochet, mark it. So this is your first stitch of this new row, and then I will do my front post treble crochets or triple crochets here, and then I will see you again when I'm at the end. Oh no, before we do it, take a look. You know, you have done here your double crochet, and this is the first post that you will work around, so after the double crochet. So I'm nearly at the end of this row again. So you can see here, here's the last stitch, and I still have to do one more front post treble crochet here around this last double crochet of the previous row. So I will finish that, and then I will do an increase in this last stitch. So do two double crochets. So count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So I'm still doing fine. So now you can see that these side on the lower side and the upper side are going in a straight line. And well, you repeat these two rows again and again. And then I will see you back in video number 3 on how to do the last part where we do only decreases on both sides.